Hello everyone, I welcome you to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how to install Shotcut Video Editor in Windows 10 operating system. So, let's begin. Now, before installing Shotcut, let us first understand why to use Shotcut. Now, Shotcut is basically a free and open source video editor. So, many of the video editor that you'll be seeing available in the market are mostly paid one. But Shotcut is one of the very few free video editing software that are, you can use for editing your video at pro level. So, it is always recommended to use Shotcut Video Editor if you want to use any free video editing software. So let us see how we can download and install Shotcut Video Editor. So for that, just simply go to your favorite browser and in here just simply type Shotcut Video Editor, then enter, and then you'll be seeing the shotcut.org is basically our first search result. So now just simply click on the Shotcut home, and this will automatically going to redirect you to this official website of Shotcut. Here you need to simply click on this click to download. This is an ad, so just simply close this, and this will going to redirect you to the Shotcut's official website. In here they have given these two sites. So I am using 64-bit operating system, so what I'll be doing is just simply clicking on this Windows installer. So just simply click on that, and this will going to redirect you to this ForceHub official website. In here, if you just simply scroll down a bit, you'll be getting the Shotcut 64-bit. You'll be getting the Shotcut 64-bit Windows installer, and the file size is 73 MB. So all you need to do is you need to just simply clicking on the Shotcut 64-bit Windows installer, and this will going to start automatically your video Shotcut Video Editor. I have already downloaded it, so just simply cancel it. And if I just simply minimize my browser, and if I just simply go to my download directory, you can clearly see our Shotcut has been rightly downloaded over here, and the file size is 73 MB. To install our Shotcut, you need to just simply double clicking on it, and then after clicking on this yes to give administrative privileges, let us first minimize our download directory, and you can clearly see our Shotcut setup wizard has been rightly opened, and currently it's now showing this license agreement. You can always read that if you have time. Right now I just simply going to click on I agree, and this is going to be your installation destinations, that is this C program files Shotcut. If you want to change your installation destination, you need to just simply clicking on this browse button, and you can change that. In this video I'm going to keep this all default, and here it's telling that you need to have 281 MB of free space in your C directory. This is very important, guys. You need to have this much amount of free space in your C directory. Currently, I am having 37.8 GB of free space in my C directory. So I have sufficient amount of space in my C directory. So do check all this and then just simply click on next. So these are the files that you are going to be installed. So I'd also like to check this create desktop shortcut icon so that it will also create a desktop shortcut icon over here so that I can use this Shotcut at ease. So just simply check this and just simply click on install for installation, and then it will going to start installing our Shotcut. You can always click on this show details, and you can see that the installation is actually happening right at the back end. It will take some time, maybe a minute or two. So for which I'll be coming back after installing Shotcut Video Editor. Yeah, so welcome back. And now as you can clearly see, our Shotcut Video Editor has been rightly installed. So just simply click on close, and you can clearly see our Shotcut Video Editor icon has also been created. To open our Shotcut Video Editor, just simply double clicking on it, and this will going to launch our Shotcut Video Editor. And here you can clearly see our Shotcut Video Editor is now currently launching. So this is basically the interface of our Shotcut Video Editor. So let us first maximize it. Now I am going to show you how we can open a new video file and how we can edit it. So for that, just simply click on this open file. And in my desktop, I have a video inside this WYSIWYG directory called this video. So just simply click on that and then just simply click on open. And you can clearly see our video has been, you know, rightly opened over here. So all you need to do is you need to just simply select the video and then drag it over your playlist. So then you'll be getting this under playlist, your video has been, you know, rightly added over here. And then you need to add, and then you need to again drag that same video inside your this section called timeline. So just, you know, simply do that, and then you'll be seeing under your timeline your entire video has been, you know, rightly added over here. You need to simply add this till, you know, this 000 second, so that, you know, it's going to start from the beginning. And if you just simply move this cursor, you'll be able to, you know, change your video sequence. Let's say you want to cut over here at this timestamp. Let's say you want to cut. So for that, you need to just, you know, simply clicking on this split at playhead, and you know, just simply click on that, and you'll be getting this split. So if you just simply delete that, let's say you want to delete that, and if you just simply play it right from the beginning, so you know, simply drag your cursor till at the front, and if you just simply play that, this video will going to last only for 6 seconds because you have cut your remaining video, right? Just, you know, simply Control Z to get back your remaining part of the video. Let's say you want to cut only this much. So just simply do that, then select your that remaining part of a video, then simply click on this icon, the split at playhead icon, and then you'll be getting another cut. If you want to simply delete this middle portion, so just, you know, simply select that and then simply click on delete button, and then, you know, just simply click on the other section of the video and then simply drag it and join it over here, and you'll be getting a new cut over here. So if you just again simply click on play button, you can clearly see a new sequence starting after this section. If you want to have a smooth transition, you need to just, you know, simply select that and then just simply drag it a little to your till your previous video. So drag it, and then you'll be getting a smooth transition over here. So now if you just simply set your cursor to earlier part, and if you just simply clicking on this play button, you'll be getting a smooth transition. You can clearly see there has been, you know, a smooth transition. So in this way you can edit your video. There are so many other features that I'd like to also explain you in my following video. So for that, do subscribe our channel and do press that bell icon so that you can get notified, and also please do comment in your comment section so that I get motivated and I'll be making more videos on Shotcut. So do let me know about that in our comment section. And now I'll also like to show you how you can export this video. So for that, you need to just simply clicking on this export icon, and then in here just simply click on this H264 high profile. Just, you know, simply click on that, and then just, you know, simply click on this export file, and this will, you know, going to open your this window called export file. So I'm going to, you know, save this file in my this desktop icon called WYSIWYG. So let us give a output name called output, file name as output, then the file type is .mp4, then just simply click on save. And here you can clearly see under this jobs section your video file is now currently, you know, rendering, and they're going to, you know, properly render all these edits that we have rightly done over here. It's now currently 8%, so it will, you know, going to take some time to complete till 100%. Meanwhile, let me show you my official website. So here you can clearly see I have this official website called geekyscript.com. In here, if you just scroll down a bit, you'll be getting many tutorials along with some blogs that I have written. So do check our website geekyscript.com. And now it has, you know, rightly finished till 25%, so it will take some time. So what I'll be doing is I'll be coming back after completion of these tasks. Yeah. So we'll come back. And now as you can clearly see, our task has been rightly completed and our output.mp4 file has been rightly created. So just simply minimize shortcut video editor, and then I have rightly saved inside this Vizac folder. So here if you just simply click on that output file, you'll be getting that this file has been rightly created and the file size is 78.8 MB and the video resolution is 1920x180. So just simply double click on it to open our outputted file, and you can clearly see our file has been rightly opened over here. At the 5th or 6th second, you'll be getting a transition, and so here basically this transition, you can see this transition. So in this way you install Shotcut Video Editor, and then I have also shown you how you can edit a simple video in your Shotcut Video Editor. So that's basically all about this video. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.